and controversial 26-21 win over the Dallas Cowboys. For more on the game, the man with the call, Wayne Larrabee, joins us this morning. Hey, Wayne.
How you doing?
Great. So many big plays out of that game, and I feel like there's several big plays. They get kind of lost in the shuffle after the way that game ended with the Dez Bryant catch, no catch, and so on. And a play that we talked about on the postgame show last night, Julius Peppers, when all 6 seconds of the frame was needed to strip DeMarco Murray of the football, this game could have been entirely different. Right. Yeah. And Peppers doesn't make that play.
Oh, tremendously different. The only turnover the Cowboys had of the ball game, but it was huge because it was third quarter. Dallas is leading at that point in time, 14-10, I believe it was, at that stage of the game. It's the second play of the drive for the Cowboys. DeMarco Murray's got a free lane. I mean, it's at the Dallas 41. He's got a lane, and he's going all the way. And Pepper stripped that football. The Packers recovered, and then they put together a field goal drive from there to get right back in and down one.
Just an amazing play in that game, and Gene brought this up earlier. We were seeing some plays, and I think you alluded to it on the broadcast. We saw some plays yesterday that reminded us of some of the losses the Packers have had at Lambeau Field in the playoffs.
Yeah.
A play that ended up bouncing the Packers' way. Randall Cobb, safe as can be, right? Returning kicks. He fumbles. Andrew Corliss, who isn't even on that unit to begin with, typically recovers the ball. Otherwise, Dallas got the ball in the red zone.
I would have to say, as you got after the Packers' first offensive possession, from then on through midway through the third quarter, it felt like so many of those home playoff disappointments of recent years. And I said that on the air. It just felt that way. I mean, the offense wasn't in sync. Aaron Rodgers was missing passes he normally completes in his sleep. We knew what was going on. We knew that due to the injury, he wasn't able to practice as much in the last 3 weeks. That makes a difference. So I thought, for them to get up off the mat like that and kind of turn things around, Peppers made two or three key plays, very subtle but key plays in that ballgame that kept Packers alive.
That second half, Aaron Rodgers, he looked different. He looked more comfortable for some reason. In your opinion, Wayne, did he just start to trust his leg a little more, or did he throw caution to the wind and say, look, we got to pull this game out?
I thought Aaron was very smart with his body and what he was asking it to do, and especially staying in the pocket in that first half. But in the second half, what they did, Greg, was they decided, okay, we're going to open this thing up. We're going to see if we can find a rhythm with this passing attack, because what do Green Bay Packers do best? They throw the football. So all of a sudden, you don't see a running back. The running back becomes Randall Cobb. He goes in motion half the time out of the backfield. So you've got Rodgers in an empty and five receivers out there. They spread out the Cowboys. They knew the Cowboys didn't have the personnel to cover all those receivers. And, unlikely heroes step up in playoff games. And I don't care what anyone says. I know Davante Adams is a second-round draft choice. Had a nice game against New England. But since that game, in the last 3 weeks, in the middle of flu season, he couldn't catch a cold. And he had caught, four passes in the last 3 weeks. What does he do yesterday? He makes the biggest play for the Packers in that game, that huge pass play for the touchdown that gave them the lead, 46 yards, 29 of it. 29 of those yards came after he broke a tackle. And you sat there and said, okay, now this is why they drafted him in the first round. Because all these receivers we're talking about, all these rookie receivers, have huge numbers in the NFL. Davante Adams, decent numbers for a rookie, but not the big knockout numbers that all these other guys have, like the guy in New York, the guy in Carolina. You can name six of those guys. But Davante Adams yesterday played, he was a man. And that's the reason why they drafted him, that big pass play.
Quick thought on Seattle going up there. Are they a different team, just like the Packers are a different team at this point of the season?
Yeah, I think so. I think they're better offensively. And I think they got Percy Harvin, the cancer, out of that locker room. And they're playing with a lot of confidence and most athletic defense in the game. That's going to be interesting.
Great stuff, Wayne. Appreciate it. We'll hear you on...